How to get a cybersecurity job in 30 days without going to college. In this video, we'll cover some tips, some guidance, and we'll go over a complete checklist that goes from day one to day 30. So at the end of day 30, you'll end up with a job in cybersecurity. A little disclaimer, 30 days is a fairly aggressive timeline. So this does require a big commitment on your part. It is completely doable. It just requires a commitment from you to accomplish this. Also, this video assumes and this checklist assumes that you do not already have the Security Plus certification, because we'll be going over that specific credential as a stepping stone into cybersecurity. Because the Security Plus certification is in great demand and is one of the foundational certifications that can help launch your cybersecurity career. A little background on Christian Espinoza with Alpine Security. Alpine Security provides cybersecurity training and consulting. We hire a lot of cybersecurity professionals. We hire people without college degrees that are certified and that meet our core values. So we know what employers are looking for. All right, if you made it this far in the video, you must be committed to getting a job in cybersecurity in 30 days. In this portion of the video, we'll go over this checklist that you see on the screen. The checklist is really a framework for your day one to day 30. So you take the proper steps along the way in order to come out after day 30 employed, or at least with a job offer in cybersecurity. Again, this assumes you do not have the Security Plus certification, because that's the basis for this framework. At least a huge part of it is getting that certification. The link to download this framework or this checklist will be put somewhere in this video as well, or beneath the video. So on day one, the first thing you need to do is sign up for the Security Plus exam and schedule this 23 days out. It's critical you sign up on day one so you have it on the calendar. That makes it real and tangible for you. The link to sign up is below there in the checklist. Also on day one, it's important to kind of figure out what study habits or what study methods work best for you. There's lots of ways to prepare for the Security Plus exam. On the screen, there's a few examples in this checklist. There's free video training. There's a link there from Professor Messer. Those are good videos you can watch for free. It's about 14 hours of free instruction. There's a study guide here you can order from Amazon. It's a good study guide. You can also sign up for a Security Plus bootcamp, which is a course you take either in person or live online, and there's a link there as well for that. And you could do a combination of all three of those. It's whatever works best for you. It's up to you to figure this out though. Days 1 through 22, it's critical that you develop block time or time blocks. This means each day you set aside a specific window of time that you focus on one specific task pertaining to getting the job in cybersecurity. The task could be watching those videos. It could be doing practice exams. It could be practicing your interview skills, but you set aside a block of time and that's all you focus on during that block of time, also known as monotasking. This means shut off all distractions, purely focus on that so you can make the most of your time. Block the time for your study methods. Could be the video, could be your boot camp, could be reading the book. Also make time for practice tests. It's very important you go over many practice exams so you're familiar with how things are asked on the exam. There's a link there for free practice questions, and there's other ones you can find on the internet as well. During days 1 through 22, research companies that are hiring Security Plus certified people with limited experience or entry level positions. You can go on Indeed.com, search by CompTIA Security, leave off the plus, otherwise it skews results, and then filter your results by entry-level positions. Then you can further sort those jobs by which ones do not require a college degree. Some of them will say a college degree is preferable, but they won't say it's required. When you've gone through this, create a list of 25. Put these in a Word document, Excel, Notepad, whatever you want. The 25 top companies or top job openings for you that you think will be a good match. Build that list. Within days 1 to 22, make sure you set aside a block of time to update your resume. If you don't have a resume, you need to create a resume. You can search on Google for different resume building services or templates. There's lots of resume templates out there. There's even like one in Microsoft Word. There's plenty to download and find out. The actual format of the resume is less important than the content of the resume. Again, in days 1 through 22, we're still in that block. Prepare for your interview. So start preparing for interviews. A lot of people make the mistake of getting certified, getting a great resume, but they don't practice interviews. There's a link here from Indeed. Read that article, practice interviews, have somebody else ask you questions, and be prepared when you walk into an interview. Days 18 through 20, start applying for those top 25 jobs you looked at. Go ahead and start applying for them and let the organization know that you're working on the Security Plus and you'll have it by this date, or that's your anticipated date of acquiring it. This starts the dialogue with those companies. Day 23 through 25, go ahead and take the Security Plus exam. You already scheduled it. So show up, take the exam, and hopefully you pass the exam. If you do not pass the exam, it's not the end of the world. Wait a day, study that day, go over the stuff you missed, the areas that caught you off guard, and then retake it 2 days later. There is no waiting period between the first time you take the Security Plus exam and the next time. If you do pass it, either the first time or the second time, update your resume, add the credential, the Security Plus credential, and then email all those 25 companies you already reached out to and let them know you have acquired the Security Plus exam. So you've already established a line of communication with them. Now you're following up with them. So this shows that you're interested and you're committed because you said you would do something and you did it. So it helps you establish a line of communication with those companies. It helps you get your foot in the door for the interview, which is the next step. So days 26 through 30 are the interviews. You should have practiced the interviews. You should be ready to go, and you should do a great job of the interviews. And hopefully, after these 30 days, or even before, or a little bit after, you'll land a job in cybersecurity. These days can shift a little bit. This is just a rough guidance on this checklist here. But it's critical you not only get certified, it's critical you search for the jobs that will meet your criteria of not having a degree and having entry-level experience. It's also critical you make sure your resume looks awesome. I didn't mention it too much here, but you need to tweak your resume for each company's job opening. One of the things that people do, one of the mistakes people make, is they'll send a generic resume to every company. If a company is asking for something specific, tweak your resume to leverage your background and tie it to what they're asking for. So you should really have a unique resume that you send for each of those 25 openings. And then, like as I mentioned, practice the interviews. Let us know how the process goes for you. I'm sure you'll do great. Best of luck.